Alright, we're gonna solve this equation, and notice that we have two square roots, right? But the good thing is that this square root is isolated already, so we can just go ahead and square both sides, because that way we can cancel this square root right away. So let's do that. I'll take this raised to a second power, and I'll put a big parenthesis like this. I'll take this raised to the second power as well. So for the first one here, this and that will cancel, and we just end up with 5x minus 4 right here. And then on the right hand side, notice that we have two terms, 1 plus the square root, right? Two terms, and then this is raised to a second power. And I will recommend you guys to write this down somewhere on the side and work it out. And I will put this down right here for you guys. This means we have to work out this right here. 1 plus square root of 3x plus 1, and then write it down again, 1 plus square root of 3x plus 1. And then just multiply this out. Let's draw the arrows to keep track. First, we do 1 times 1. Of course, this is just 1. Next, 1 times this. 1 times this square root, we have just that square root. So I'll write down the square root of 3x plus 1. And then next, we take this times 1, which is just that, plus square root of 3x plus 1. And the last one is this times that. The square root times square root and the insides are the same, right? So when you multiply this and that together, you just have the inside. You just have 3x plus 1. So at the end, we add the inside, 3x plus 1. Is there anything that we can do? So are there any things we can combine? Yes, let's see. And just a style, let's put down the x terms first. Notice that we do have the 3x. Let's put that down right here first. And we have the 1 plus 1. Well, that will give us plus 2. And notice that this radical and that radical are alike, right? So we can just do plus 1 here, plus 1. So we have a total of plus 2. Radical of the inside stays the same, 3x plus 1. We combine these two radicals together, we have two of them. So this right here is the work for that right there. And now we can just come back here and continue. I'll write this down over here. We have 3x plus 2, and then plus 2 square root of 3x plus 1. And now by looking at this equation, you see that we still have this square root right here. That's not good. And the deal is that we have to get rid of the square root. Well, first, we have to isolate this square root first. With that being said, let's minus 3x on both sides. So I'll put this down right here, minus 3x here, and minus 3x, so that this and that will be out. And then this is plus 2. So that's minus 2 here, so that this and that will be out. So I'll minus 2 here as well. And let's see what we end up with. We are going to have 5x minus 3x, that's 2x, and then negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6, and then we have the equal, and notice that this 2 stays with the square root, right? They are together. We have 2 times the square root of 3x plus 1, like this. And now, this is 2 times this square root, so what can we do to get rid of this 2? This is multiplying, so we have to divide. Let me divide this by 2, so that this will cancel. On the left-hand side, we also have to divide everything by 2, right? So let's divide this by 2, and I'll divide this by 2. I'm working this out individually. So right here, you see that 2 over 2 is just 1, and then we have the x right here. And then minus 6 over 2 is minus 3. And then this is equal to the square root of 3x plus 1. Pretty nice, huh? And now, this square root is isolated on the right-hand side. Well, I can square this side, right? So that this and that will cancel. But then, I will also have to come here and square this right here. We have to work out x minus 3 squared. So, with that being said, let's just do the work on the side right here again. Similar to this, but this time it's actually easier because no more square root inside of this parentheses. So, let me put this down right here. X minus 3 times x minus 3, and then let's just multiply it out this real quick. X times x will give us x squared, x times negative 3, that's negative 3x, and then negative 3 times x, this is negative 3x, this and that give us negative 6x, right? Combine like terms. At the end, negative 3 times negative 3, that'll give us plus 9. So just multiply that out. So this is going to give us that x squared minus 6x plus 9, and this is equal to square and square root cancel. We just have the inside 3x plus 1. Whew. Finally, an equation that has no square root. And this is an x to the second power. This is a quadratic situation, which will make one side equal to 0 and then factor the other. So let's make this side equal to 0. Let me subtract 3x on both sides so that this and that will be out. And then let me minus 1 on both sides so that this and that will be out. And you will see this is going to be x squared and negative 6x minus 3x is negative 9x. And we have 9 minus 1, which is plus 8. And this is equal to 0, right? And let me just continue my work right here. How can I factor this out? Well, this is just 1x squared. I know I must have parentheses, parentheses, x and x, right? Okay, what times 12 give us positive 8? Together, they should add up to negative 9. Well, the response for that will be negative 1, negative 8. And then this is an equation. Don't forget to put this down. This is equal to 0. And now, this times this is equal to 0. I'm going to make the first factor equal to 0. So x minus 1 is equal to 0. And then x minus 8 is equal to 0. Add 1 on both sides here. So we know x is equal to 1. Right here, we add 8 to both sides. So another possible answer is just 8. Whew, we did all the work. And then we end up with 1 and 8. However, remember, whenever we're dealing with equation that has square roots, be sure to check our answer, because sometimes we may get some fake answer, right? Therefore, I'm going to check this first. So this is just going to be my check. And to do the check, we're plugging 1 into the very original equation. So let me put this down right here. We will have square root of 5 times x is 1, so I'll put it down right here. And then we have minus 4 in the square root like this. Is this the same as the right-hand side, which is 1, plus square root of 3 and the x is 1, and then you add the 1 inside like this. So let's see. Let's do this in your head. 5 times 1 is 5. Minus 4 is 1. Square root of 1 is just 1, right? So this is just 1. On the right-hand side, this is equal to 1. Plus, we have 3 times 1 is 3, plus 1 is 4, and this is pretty much square root of 4. Let me write it down. But then you see, this is going to give us 1 plus 2. And earlier, you see, once again, 5 minus 4 is 1 in the square root, and then square root of 1 is 1. But right here, you can see that 1 is not equal to 1 plus 2. You don't have to work out everything. You know this is wrong. Therefore, x equals 1. It's actually a wrong answer, right? It's a fake answer. So we'll take this out. It's fake, so just get rid of that. Does that mean 8 is legit? Well, I cannot promise. I will have to do the check as well. That's plugging 8 into the original equation, the x here and also the x here. So we will have square root of 5 times 8, and then we minus a 4 from here. Is this the same as 1 plus square root of 3 times x, which is the 8, and then inside here we have a plus 1. And now let's see. 5 times 8 is 40, minus 4 is 36, and then we have the square root, right? So you know this is going to be 6. Well, is this the same as 1 plus 3 times 8 is 24, plus 1 is 25 inside. Well, you know this is 1, this is 5. 6 is equal to 1 plus 5. Of course, this is right. So what does that mean? That means x is equal to 8. It's legit, right? And therefore, this is actually the only answer. X is equal to 8. Be sure you do not include 1 for the answer. this is the only one.